Seemingly after a long period of debating the merits of doing so, two ultra-fast-track initiatives have developed in recent days that could send humans back to the moon, not by 2028 or the usual long-term timeframes we're used to that are ever prone to cancellation or delay, but by next year. The first comes from Elon Musk and SpaceX. There's no question Mr. Musk is bold and visionary when it comes to exploring space, and his latest announcement is fully in line with his past accomplishments and plans. I still to this day marvel at the sight of one of his rocket stages landing itself perfectly on target. But now, he wants to send tourists on a looping trip around the moon. Now, we don't know who these tourists are just yet, only that a pair of wealthy individuals have put down a deposit with SpaceX. The plan is highly ambitious because the Falcon Heavy rocket needed for the trip hasn't made its first flight yet. That's set to happen this summer. And the Dragon capsule system, while it's been reliably ferrying supplies to the ISS, has not flown humans, but the crew version is also set to make its maiden voyage at the end of this year, and the first manned flight to the ISS is slated for early 2018. But this new moon mission is also slated for late 2018. Mr. Musk states that the modifications needed to the Falcon and Dragon would not be that extensive, though it will certainly need to carry extra fuel, food, oxygen, etc. The mission would last just under a week and would be significantly more dangerous than a trip to the ISS, where there are possibilities for rescue if something goes wrong. On a trip to the moon, this is not so easy, but Musk points out his space tourists full well know the risks. Now, this isn't just for space tourism purposes, but bolsters and moves forward Musk's ultimate plan of colonizing Mars. Now, it always pays to be skeptical when it comes to timelines and space exploration. They very typically fudge and get pushed back. This goes for NASA or SpaceX, which has had its mishaps and delays too. But kudos once again to Elon Musk for being bold. The second initiative is a bit more murky and is rapidly developing at this time. The incoming White House administration has requested that NASA look into sending a crew on the maiden voyage of the Space Launch System and its accompanying Orion capsule. By delaying it until 2019, NASA may in fact be able to make it a manned mission to basically do the same thing that SpaceX has proposed, loop around the moon. I'm not sure this is a good use of resources since NASA rockets invariably cost billions of dollars more to launch than SpaceX ones do, though I suppose it could also be said that there's something to competition, and NASA was going to launch the rocket anyway to test it out. And then there's Jeff Bezos with his Blue Origins rockets, which promised to rival SpaceX in the not-too-distant future that is sure to make for an even more competitive environment in space exploration. We could eventually see a sort of new space race built on the competition between NASA, Boeing with its new spacecraft, the CST-100, ULA, SpaceX, and Blue Origin, and I don't think we've heard the last from Richard Branson either. We seem poised to see a major new push into manned space exploration. SpaceX and Blue Origin, particularly due to their cost model, have finally seemed to break down the biggest barrier in space exploration, the enormous cost of it. It will be an interesting few years indeed. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently wondering if I would ever hop in a capsule and loop around the moon. I think not. Mars is more my style. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.